So there's four types of secondary storage you will need to know about. And secondary storage essentially allows you to store things from your computer. So it allows you to save things, basically, because computers wouldn't be much good if every time you turn them off, they erased all of the data in them, which is what happens with RAM. So you need a bit of secondary storage in order to save your data. And there's a few different sort of types available. You've got magnetic storage, which comes in the form of hard drives. And hard drives are pretty cheap in terms of sort of what they give you in terms of storage. So you can buy sort of 1 terabyte, 2 terabyte hard drives pretty cheaply nowadays. So they store a lot of data. They're reasonably quick in terms of access for data, but they can be slightly sort of fragile. So you can even see from the diagram here, the hard drive's got several moving parts. So it's got an actuator arm which moves, a disk which spins thousands and thousands of times per minute. So if you dropped a hard drive, potentially your data could sort of disappear because the hard drive could break and then you can't recover your data. The next type of storage we've got is what's known as optical storage. So this could be a CD, a DVD, or a Blu-ray. And optical storage is very, very cheap, but you have certain issues with it in that it's, again, reasonably sort of prone to damage. You know, any sort of scratches on the surface of the disc here then can make your data sort of disappear, essentially, and make you not able to access it. But they are cheap. They're very or reasonably portable. I mean, you know what the size of a CD and a DVD is. But they're sort of reasonably low storage. I mean, you're talking a CD is about 700 meg. A DVD is about sort of 4.7 meg. Blu-ray discs can vary anything from sort of 25 meg to 25 gigabytes to 50 gigabytes. I should say the Blu-ray is about 4.7 gigabytes, not megabytes. So the storage is reasonably small compared to the other options here, but they're cheap and they're pretty portable, but quite prone to damage. Our next one is the solid state drive. And a solid state drive is much like a hard drive. It's quite high capacity. Solid state capacity is improving all the time. And, you know, you can buy some quite high capacity solid state drives. The advantages here is they're very, very quick to access data from, much quicker than hard drives. So you'll probably find if you've got a solid state drive in your computer, it boots up very quickly. And this is also why phones and tablets start up very quickly, because they use solid state drives in them, or solid state chips rather than drives. Solid state is quite expensive still compared to a hard drive. You don't get as much data as you do with a hard drive, with a solid state drive for the money. They're less prone to damage because, as their name suggests, they have no moving parts. So you can do all sorts of things with them, and generally your data will be quite safe. Okay. So they are the sort of advantages and disadvantages of the solid state drive. And then finally, we've got cloud storage, okay? And cloud storage, as hopefully you know, doesn't live up there in fluffy clouds. It's actually, data, what they call data centers, which have banks and banks and banks of servers and hard drive, which store your data. So you can see actually in this picture, there's all the fans there that keep the hard drives and the servers inside these units cool, okay? And basically, cloud storage, have to pay for it mostly. You do get sort of free ones, but you don't get very much storage. But if you pay for it, you can get quite a lot of storage. Advantages being that your data is stored sort of away from you. So if your device gets stolen or there's a fire in your house and you lose everything, your data is still perfectly safe because it's stored somewhere in America or somewhere else in the world. Disadvantages are, yes, it is stored somewhere else, so potentially your data is subject to different laws than we have in the UK. You also need an internet connection to be able to upload and download the data that you have. But keeps your data secure, and it's reasonably cheap and cost-effective to use cloud storage. So those are the four types of secondary storage you will need to know about.